Hi everyone, today we're playing ABZU, or ABZU, or ABZU, or omelette du fromage. I'm not sure about the pronunciation, to be honest. It's from some or more of the creators of Journey. Not entirely sure exactly if it's the same people, or some of the same people, or just the art designer or something, but there's some ties to Journey, and much like Journey, I'm probably just gonna go through this whole thing in one long session, because that just felt right for that game, and it'll probably feel right for this one too. Am I playing? Are we having... Oh. Thought we might be having the beginning of a limbo moment there. Well, big advantage over the guy from Journey. We have arms. That's not a bad start. Having arms. Oh, I think I'm playing now. Oh, yep. Press right trigger to dive. What if I just want to swim around for a little bit? Is that a coastline off in the distance? Look at that. There's like rocks, I think. You can see that there's a hand-drawn sky, which seems to be reflected in the water. Ooh. So, I hate the ocean. It terrifies me, and this is a whole game in the ocean, so... Yay. Good start for me, right off the bat. Doesn't seem like a very hydrodynamic helm, does it, with a little, like... almost cat ears spiking out. It does make my character have an oddly robotic appearance in what's otherwise going to be probably a very natural and dreamy and swimmy game. So here's a weird quirk. Your left stick does not control where you go. It specifically controls your direction of your character's tilt. You actually have to hit A to swim. So A is how you paddle, but otherwise you're just steering yourself. So I immediately tried to press forward. Oh, you have to keep pressing it too, it looks like. I tried pressing forward to move, but it made me flip over. So it looks like A is how we kick. Can I hold it down? But if I keep hammering it, oh yeah, it definitely stops and starts over and over again, which is slightly surprising. You'd kind of want to have like a continuous kick, I think. Then, oh, hey. Oh! It introduced right trigger as being dive, but it's really just continually swim forward, then I guess... Ooh, look at that. That's what happens when you hit A while you're diving. This is a swarm. It's running very well. I set all the graphics to ultra this time. They start off on high, which I presume is probably what it runs on console. Hi. Friend? Ooh. This is Aquaman Simulator. When the movie comes out, they can just change the character model, and then they're all set. How does this person create the most beautiful things in video games? Wow. Let's look around. Are there any, like, details to home in on? There's a few paths. That one seems to go off in the distance. I'm curious about this one. It seems to dead end. Oops. Moving will take a little practice. I keep wanting to turn the camera with the right stick instead of left. And that's not this game. Hello. Did I just unleash a new type of fish into the biome? Were there trumpet fish earlier, or did I just unleash those? That's crazy. Oh, and that one ran into me. Look at those guys. Oh. Are they eating? Can I watch them eat? Is that what's happening? Oh, they're actually eating other fish! Makes you feel slightly bad for it, doesn't it? It's like, oh, what have I done? I have disrupted the biome. What's down here? Well, you're so- oh, it's a helm. No, it's a drone or a camera? It's like Soma, brought to you by Disney Pixar. I don't know what form that film would take, but I'd be concerned. Is it gonna follow me around? Look at it go. Hey, little guy. The seahorses. Oh, this is nice. Let's boost. Yeah. We have another one. What's this one gonna do? Are we gonna keep changing the biome here? Oh. Cool, no, I was hoping we'd put sharks in here. Thanks. Thanks for that. Are they gonna also just nom away? I suppose we're surrounded by better targets, so it'd be weird to go after me. There's a shark. Can I see him going after someone? Going straight for the school? No, I don't see an explosion of murder. That grouper I rode in on is way larger than any of the other fish around here. Oh. It's like a shark sphinx. How does that happen? Can I interact? So you meditate and you kind of just home in on fish and experience what's going on. So that was a grouper. The black sea bass. Sebastian SB. An anchovy, the tiny, tiny green fish. I was hoping on like a trumpet fish or something. That's another anchovy. Leopard shark, there's one. Oh, I can rotate the camera and everything. It's like screensaver mode. Like, hey, let's just enjoy what's going on around us right now. I mean, this is immediately fairly engaging, considering that historically, underwater environments are the least fun thing in any video game. Oh, cool, now I have swimming controls and I hate my life. Thanks, video games. Let's find a ooh, Black Sea Bass got some dinner. I want to chase around a trumpet fish for a bit if I can. Female California Shepherd. Sheephead, not Shepherd. That's not what a sheephead looks like at all, silly developers. / marine biologists. Ooh! That started off as a close-up of an orange fish, and it quickly became a predator situation. Whoa, how often do you eat? You're gonna run out of, like, body mass to replace with food. Whoa. Did we just watch that guy just dive into the middle of this crew and take them all out? This is great. I really wanted to see a trumpet fish, but I don't know if I'll be able to find one easily. I don't have a lot of control over who a trap chooses to go after. There's a shark again. So the sharks are actually surprisingly the passive party we're seeing today. Is it gonna get him? Nope. Yeah, I haven't seen the sharks do much eating so far. Probably enough meditation for now. Hey, buddy. What you doing? Seriously, do you do something? I don't know what to think about you. Oh, he chimes at you. Oh, look at that. I wonder if he can be controlled by a multiplayer character like in Journey. We have the chime system. Oopsie. Don't chime back and forth when you're on one of those. You get stuck to it. Alright, let's get away from it for a little bit. Alright, let's test out the capacity of this. Some of the fidelity is lost. I tried for something slightly more complicated and it kinda doesn't quite repeat. Oh, there's another one over here. Look at this guy. Hey. Will you be my friends? I don't have any friends. Yeah? Interesting how one of the... Oh, they make little, like, droidy sounds. Only one of them responds at a time, interestingly. Yeah. You chime and one of them responds to you in each moment. What does this look like from the surface, I wonder? Oh, that's... solid. Oh yeah, you can see it all from up here. It was just the starting area that was really undetailed underwater. So that's not a shoreline, this is all like, it's like a kelp forest is what I was seeing in the distance. Oh! There seems to be a boat or a wreckage over there. That's probably a good target to look for. And what is this over here? Oh, it's a cliff, okay. Thought there might be something there. Yeah, I'm getting the hang of it now, and the swimming controls feel pretty good. Have I activated you yet? Oh, we got sea turtles! Oh yeah. There we go. Sea turtles for days. So I'm just gonna come out and say it right from the get-go. I already get the feeling I'm gonna miss stuff playing this game, because it's actually looks fairly dense. Hello. Definitely exploration focused. All right, we have little hermit crabs or something that flee. What's your deal? Oh. It has joined my inventory apparently. We got urchins. Don't want to touch those. My dad got a very long-lasting, call it a stipple brand, basically, where he had a series of purple dots on his leg from encountering a sea urchin in a less than favorable fashion. Don't touch them. And definitely don't sit on them on accident, or, in our case, dive in relatively shallow waters for snorkeling, and then have the waves dip away from you and plunge you down into the coral below. And you get to encounter whatever was on the surface directly below you. More than you'd like to. It definitely activated you already. Let's press forward a little bit. It's interesting how robotic and cubey I am. Like, I am very polygonal. Like, you can see, like, triangles all over my body that make up my really simple frame when nothing around me looks like that. So, like, I'm very mechanical. And my little drone friends are very mechanical, but even they look a little more organic than I do. But you can see they're sort of flatter surfaces here and there. It's like it's trying to reinforce the difference, the gap in space between our more the fact that we're not from here. Basically, everything here fits together except for us. There we go. Yay! They've imprinted upon me, and now we are friends forever, or until some hazard takes them out, maybe. Because I may have needed them for the... Oh no! Is one of them gonna get destroyed? What's gonna happen here? Oh cool, he seems fine. Yay. I'm always ready for these games to destroy my heart. Journey was at many points not a happy game. Oh, this is great. The colors. That's a great white. No, shark teeth missiles. Not a big fan of sharks and many other things underwater. So the ocean's scary inherently. It's beautiful. but it's scary because you can't survive down there on your own, and pretty much anything can strand you down there. People literally just go down in caves and just drown in them. Kind of like this, actually. going in a cave is actually incredibly dangerous. It's not the same thing as diving. If you dive in a cave, you lose all perspective of up and down because you can't see you can't see up anymore properly, and it's very easy to get confused, disoriented, and lost, and run out of air, and just die down there. Especially if you get stuck on anything, and no one will ever know that you're in trouble. But sharks are messed up too, because they're like missiles, basically, like torpedoes. They're designed after just eons of evolution, of years of evolution, to basically just surf through the water. Surf's the wrong word, but just shoot through it at lightning speeds, and their entire face is missiles. So not a fan. I mean, their entire face is teeth, not missiles. That'd be a very different kind of shark. That's the blood dragon shark. You can kick up the sand, look at that, along these cracked soils. Which might be... They're not, are they? No, they're not. I don't think they are. Don't worry about it. I was going into geology mode for a second there and thought I might have been looking at something else. That's probably not common adjoining down there, even though it does look oddly caldera-like. The walls around here in particular look vaguely like pillow basalts to some extent. I don't know if we're in a volcanic environment at all. Honestly, a lot of the ocean floor is just basalt anyway, so it's usually just a safe assumption. It's on land, on the surface of land, where things get interesting and different all the time. Ocean's kind of boring geologically a lot of the time. Hey there. Do you guys do something? Look at that. Part of me wants to try to see if there's something, a menu they're being added to, but part of me also never wants to pause this game ever and just keep it as one continuous thing. That's a nice color gradient, the green to blue. They applied it to everywhere, but it's the difference in space leads to it looking really nice. What's up here, huh? Oops, pressed up too much, did a backflip. Common real-life accidents. Should I check the water? I should probably check the surface just for a moment. Whoa. He catches momentum, by the way. He's a very effective swimmer. Almost as if he's some sort of swimming robot. Did not mean to dive. There we go. Yep, there's that one peak over there. Not really headed that way, are we? Kind of heading over here, if I remember correctly. Yeah. We'll see. Not a ton of above water details to see right now. Maybe ever. Hi. Oh, they're all kicking up sand and everything. Look at this. Look at the little starfish. The starfish is moving. How weird is it to see starfish move? Oh, it's a super starfish, covered in so many legs. Starfish are horrifying, by the way. What they do is they cover other organisms with their entire body, and then their stomach literally comes out of their body, and it digests the organism from outside the starfish, and then sucks in the nutrients and just leaves them behind. So you can watch these videos of like a giant starfish like that, all prickly and nightmarish looking, just sort of slowly crawling like this over a whole, like, field of sand dollars when they're all, like, purple and fuzzy and alive. And behind the starfish, in its trail, is just a wake of these bone-dry, white sand dollars, because they're all dead and all of their living tissue is just gone. And they're just... They literally walk through a field of living things and leave behind an actual graveyard, because starfish are horrible creatures. Yay! Mystical adventure full of whimsy and murder. Ocean's messed up. Don't go there alone, kids. Tell an adult. Oh, hey. It definitely feels like he was really into that one sort of swimmy, kelpy part of Journey and was like, let's make a whole game out of this! Yes! So we have... The surface here is grim and gray. But at the bottom of the kelp forest, there seems to be something glowing. but obviously there's a bit of worry about how exposed I might be. Is it looks like something artificial. Is this going to be a pollution game about how mankind's destroying these beautiful locations with their artificialness? I'm going to go down to the surface first just to see what's down here before we check out the glowy part. Oh yeah. A lot of wreckage. All sorts of wreckage. What a happy time for everyone.
Yeah.
Oh, look at this up close though. It's all covered in tiles and mosaics. Star and radial patterns. So while this is all weird debris, the bridge itself is like something beautiful and crafted. Down here it does look like a bridge. Oh yeah. From the surface up top, it almost looked like it was going to be a crashed submarine. But when I get closer to it, it looks like some sort of ancient ruin. Actually, now that I'm seeing up close, it looks like part of Journey. Like it's somehow underwater here. Yeah. Is this continuous with the world of Journey? Is it now underwater? Like some Legend of Zelda stuff where they say that Wind Waker is supposed to be a different part of Zelda, but many years later when everything's underwater? Okay, no! I realized when I was going up to it that it was a vortex, and I'm like, oh, maybe I don't want to go here. Maybe I want to keep exploring. Look at this. Okay. Here's where the Journey vibes definitely come in. That's the part... There was a part in that game where you kind of see drawings on walls that framework the story. And here we seem to be entering some sort of place that connects all the locations in the game, perhaps. What happens if I just go down? Can I just keep going down? Oh, no, I can't. He does not want to go underneath this underwater water surface. I'm underwater, but that over there, that's also underwater, and it's beautiful and horrifying in that it looks like a death vortex, but it's like a pretty death vortex where I'll probably die, but also, like, be blinded by its majesty while I'm torn asunder and drown in the horrible depths or something. Ooh. Feeling a little bit of never-ending story all of a sudden. Are we going to name the childlike princess? Oh, look at that. We've let out mana rays. Okay. I thought I got stuck in there permanently and we were gonna go somewhere else, but it looks like I get to come back here and explore again. So... this is an interesting conceit where we seem to be dealing with water that's underwater. Like SpongeBob, where it's already a show that takes place underwater, but then they visit the beach. Is it still horrible down there? Oh, I can't go down there. Weird. I wonder why that is, because I've already been down there before. So it's like we're restoring the place to some extent, but you gotta wonder what's going on down below the surface. And I wonder what these fish think about the idea that there's a surface of water underneath their water. Oh, you're so pretty! How do you so pretty? How does this happen? Take a look around before I go right in. Golden archway, beautiful color contrast. Every moment of this game so far has been something you'd make into like a wallpaper or something. Oh, yep. Might get some context here. Oh, look at the little lights coming on. My little helper drones help light things up. I can't wait for when this game betrays me for loving them. We have people carrying pots. They have writing. Not much to go on, just the fact that they have a civilization of some kind. Plants and pots. And writing. It's the most straightforward level. Do not touch the starfish, the jellyfish. Those will probably pain us. Got a picture of a whale. Is that a compass rose? Agriculture. Yeah, they have agriculture, they have construction. This is a proper society. And those people have shark heads. So maybe that's part of their religion, why we had a shark sphinx the other way around here. Okay, you know what, I just gotta see what happens, you know? I gotta see what happens. It's jellyfish. Jellyfish? Oh, this game's pretty non-violent, huh? I can't hurt myself with a jellyfish. Maybe I can't, huh. I mean, maybe I don't, if I'm a robot, they wouldn't be able to hurt me at all. Because, while jellyfish are often depicted as having some sort of weird lightning powers, probably because of the type of pain they inflict, what jellyfish actually do is that their tendrils are covered in tiny needles, and those needles inject venom directly into your body, and the venom causes horrible pain. And that's where that's what the jellyfish zap actually is that you get, imagine going to like a heroin clinic, and there's all those hypodermic needles, and then you thread them all with one string, and you hang them from the roof, and you have a long string covered in needles, and that's basically what all of those tentacles are on a jellyfish. They're just tons of needles hanging on a string that inject you with pain, because the ocean's horrible. Have I mentioned that before? Okay, now this is columnar jointing, isn't it? Oh yes you are. Yes you are, because you're relatively common near the ocean or anywhere where there's volcanoes. I love you, columnar jointing. I don't think I've explained this before, but columnar jointing is caused by magma that basically, as it cools, there's a tension on the surface, kind of like the tension of a bubble for water and stuff like that. And as it cools, it maintains that tension until it eventually cracks on the surface in a series of patterns that are usually kind of uniform in shape. You get a lot of like hexagonal and octagonal shapes. These are some very beautiful shorelines, and a ton of RPGs are constantly using this visual lately because it's just so striking, because it's actually... What we're looking at here is actually a real visual that happens in real life, but it looks like a fantasy setting at the same time. So it's used in almost every RPG I've been playing lately, and it's actually been a funny thing to constantly recognize over and over again. Check out this cave. Let's go! Do this to me, and it still made me sad. Aww. I was literally, like, I was moving forward, and I was about to comment on how, like, they add so much little character to these guys, because even while they're zooming along already, and they almost look curious and thoughtful and happy, they keep even while we're going full speed, they kept pausing to turn towards me over and over again, as if to continually check in on me, like, to make sure I'm okay, because I'm, like, their protector. Or the one that brought them back. And immediately that damn great white took one of them out. So now we only have two. And also, we're in the great, horrible open ocean, where we are the most vulnerable we could possibly be. There's a reason why all those organisms were inside there. A lot more things to hide behind out there. This is just the open. This is where predators get you. This is where Nemo dares not tread. Because you're just out there. And you can't see anything around you. And it's just abyss. It's the infinity. Like, immediately you see me gravitating towards any solid object to go to instead. Because it's just blue. And you don't know what's there. And like a suicidal monster, I'm going to swim straight down. And we're just gonna see what happens. Okay. Cool. There's a floor down here. Hi. I didn't want to do that. Yay! Sea turtles. They probably won't murder me. But you never know. Oh, look at these little guys. Look at them, like little mollusks. Aw. They are freaky little guys. Look at them. They're little bottom feeders, I think, is what they are. I always forget if these guys are still alive or if they're only fossils. I don't know if we're fantasy or not. It's one of those things where you get to stuff that's weird on the ocean bottom and you can't tell if they're real or if they're alive anymore or if they're made up or if they're extinct, because it all seems impossible sometimes. We got more weird wreckage. A sci-fi triangle from the sci-fi times. Howdy, y'all. Oh, it's nice down here. Once you're at the bottom of the ocean, it's kind of nice. It's just when you see it as an abyss that it gets way scarier. Also, we're not the real bottom. This ain't no trench or anything. Oh. Character doesn't want to go over there. Getting a little bit of a back and forth here where I want to find stuff, but I also don't want to wander in the nowhere forever. The place definitely kind of guides you a bit. What's over here? Maybe not much. I'd love to inject some more biodiversity around here. Other things to be eaten by sharks that are larger and easier to see and more meaty, to make them nice, good targets instead of myself and my poor, poor robot friends. I don't think sharks are supposed to be very good at detecting what's food necessarily right away. So what happened there is it was probably a test bite, which is that sharks will often bite something once, and that'll kind of help it determine whether or not it's something that they determined to be food. And then from there, they'll decide if they want to come back and try to eat the thing, or if they just throw it away and get rid of it and move on with their lives. And in our case, the bite proved fatal for our poor robot friend, as they often prove fatal for real people. Because you can get one nasty bite, and the shark doesn't even decide to eat you, but that one bite was enough to take you out. Can't I ride sea turtles? Yay! I can't wait for when that one gray white finds us in the middle of this whimsical moment. That's nice. Alright. Up to the surface, though. Or not the surface, but up towards stuff again. Up in the light, where the floor looks way scarier, because it just is an abyss of nothing. What's that? What are you? Oh, yeah, those are... from the right profile, I kind of thought it was a barracuda. Definitely not. So what is the deal with you? You're a huge, freaky sci-fi relic, and you look like you're actually blinking. What? Oh, that's way weirder. Whoa. Huh. Oh no, don't leave me. No! Oh. Well, now I'm sad. Now I'm alone.